Hello friends, I am Ikram Sharma. Welcome you to my channel. In this video, I am going to talk about Terry Eagleton's critical essay, Marxism and Literary Criticism. Marxist criticism is a specialized branch of sociological criticism. As its name shows, it is based on the teachings of Karl Marx and his companion, Friedrich Engels. The doctrine of socialism, realism, is at the base of Marxist criticism. This means that the writer is expected to reproduce reality and spread socialism through his work. Marxism belongs to the external approach of criticism because it interprets literary work in context of society. Marxists don't believe in history and religion. There are certain assumptions of Marxist literary criticism. The first assumption is, no artistic object, including literature, can be understood in isolation from the social, cultural, and historical conditions in which it was produced. The second is, literature must be understood in relation to the economic conditions of the age. Then, literature seeks to implement the ideology of the ruling class and authors write in social context. The fourth assumption is, Marxist critics make effort to find out ideologies hidden in the text. In the present essay, Marxism and Literary Criticism, Terry Eagleton defines the complicated relationship between the socio-economic base and superstructure. The issues discussed by Eagleton include base and superstructure, ideology, form and content of literature, and also function of criticism. In the beginning of the essay, Eagleton explains in detail the relationship between literature and superstructure of society. It is also a part of social ideology. Then he throws light on the other Marxist critics' views on literature. Other important Marxist critics are Lukács, Goldman, and Macquarie. The present essay is divided into two chapters. The first chapter deals with literature and history, and the second chapter deals with the concepts of form and content. First upon, we should understand the basic idea of Marxism. According to Karl Marx, there are two major classes in the capitalist society. The first is bourgeois, means controlling or rulers. The second class is proletariat, means working class. It forms a typical social structure which is based on only financial interest. Marx calls it class struggle. Marx says that the proletariat should gain the power by any means. They should be conscious about their rights. Then Eagleton explains the idea of base and superstructure. According to Eagleton, the social relations between men and are bound up with the way they produce their material life. In medieval ages, labor powers were controlled by the forces of feudalism, and in the modern age, it is controlled by the capitalist class. Marx calls these forces and relations of production as the economic structure of society. It is more commonly known as the economic base or infrastructure. So, economic interests of the society are at the base of the superstructure. This economic base influences the law and order, politics, fashion industry, media, religion, literature, etc. All financial interests are based on such broad categories in the society, and they are interconnected. Now we are moving to the next major point of the essay, which is literature and superstructure. While defining this, according to Marx, literature is also the part of the superstructure. He calls it sociology of literature. Marxist critics asserts that literature has been used to projected certain things and excluded certain things. It is also based on the interest of bourgeois. Literary works are not mysteriously inspired. They have relations with social mentality or ideology of an age. Art is the part of the superstructure. Bourgeois people spread the art as per their interest. So literature is not an independent and innocent form. Marx is of the view that the greatest artistic development does not depend on the highest development of the productive forces. For example, the Greeks produced major works of art in an economically undeveloped society. The above views of Marx are found in his work Grand Rise. It raises two questions. The first question is concerned with our relation with the past art. It is, how can it be that we moderns still find aesthetic appeal in the cultural works of the past produced in quite different societies? Marx's answer to this question is, because our own history links us to those ancient societies. Here, history is taken in its wider sense. One eminent Marxist critic, Bertolt Brecht, calls it historical sense. The phrase refers to the idea of historical sense given by T.S. Eliot, which means the whole past. The second question that rises from Grand Rise is concerned with the relation between base and superstructure. According to Marx, these two aspects of society do not form a symmetrical relationship. Each element of society's superstructure, that is law, politics, religion, etc., has its own tempo of development. Then Eagleton gives an analysis of Eliot's long poem Wasteland. From the view of vulgar Marxist, it is directly determined by ideological factors. The spiritual emptiness has sprung from the First World War, which is known as the crisis of imperialistic capitalism. But the Marxist view does not consider a whole series of levels which mediate between the text and capitalist economy. It does not speak of Eliot's social situation. It also keeps silence of the structure of the poem, its content, form, and also its language. We learn nothing from this approach about the social conditions which give birth to spirituality, Christianity, and even Buddhism, which the poem draws on. The historical sense is needed to take into account for a complete understanding of the poem. The next important point in this essay is literature and ideology. Superstructures are utilized to projecting the bourgeois ideologies. The major function of the superstructure is to foster and legitimize the bourgeois ideologies. They keep the minds of common people engaged and divert their attention from the important issues. To control someone physically is not very easy, but it is easy to control people's mind. It is known as false consciousness, which allows certain things to project and certain things to hide. According to Marx, literature is the part of superstructure and also the part of ideology. On the other hand, sometimes literature challenges the ideology it confronts. Literature and art has the capacity to reflect upon the base from which it is produced. For example, Dostoevsky, which is a Russian novelist, questioning the authority through his writing. His writings reflects upon the base from where his writing produced. Here I end the discussion on the chapter 1st of the essay. In the next video, I will cover chapter 2, which is about form and content. If you have any doubt or question regarding to this video, please ask me in the comment section below. Thank you.